Welcome back to Let's Play XCOM. Enemy unknown. I'm Hunter Black Luna. Oh, and when the door's closed on her, then the cat runs out. Well, isn't that brilliant? Great way to open the session. So anyway, last time we had a lesson on tragedy and mortality. Stuff like that. As one of the most promising soldiers in the entire project was cruelly snatched from us by an idiot. And my personal headcanon is that idiot was shot at dawn, not just dismissed. But we do what we must do and carry on. And I get this feeling that we are drawing close.
Excavation complete.
Negative on gift. Do we have anyone else we can put in? Our two newest, greenest people. Well, it's something. We've only had two people die who had nicknames, and given that it's like the undisputed late game, that's not bad. I'm gonna miss this game when I'm done. I might kick the difficulty up to classic, although that may not be something I enjoy terribly. I don't know what golem means anyway.
Online.
Oh, I'm glad it's online. We're just about out of power. I'd like another power generator down there. All we need are the miners. And we can use the ethereal device at any point. We're not exactly pressed in terms of panic. But is it blistering? Also, I've been forgetting to do this since forever. We got plasma cannons out there, isn't it? At least as many craft as we can spare. That should help. And I really do just keep forgetting to do that. And remember, Squatty is the new rookie. What was that nickname? Sin. Okay, that's a badass nickname. We got a list of badasses. So there's that. All you have to do is use the ethereal device. Is there really a reason to delay? To get better equipment, but we have late game equipment. We have all the late game equipment we need, really. And we have an absolute top-notch squad. We could boost everyone to Colonel, which would take another mission or two. Also, I'm enjoying this series immensely. It's rewarding to play okay and then be, you know, rewarded for that sort of play. What am I thinking about? Oh, right. So a little scatterbrain. We even have loot we can safely sell. A little low on corpses. Look at the variety, and we've done all of them. Enough money is to put in another power gen. generator, looks like. Also, I would value having mind shields. Greater resistance to offensive sound attacks. Almost like everything we have. I would value having at least one of those. Still have enough for carapace armor. I suppose we could do some more foundry projects. There are one or two that I would appreciate. Conservation. I really want that. Now, typically you never sell limited resources of this nature. Especially since the return on that sell is not good. But fuck it. Over here, corpses. I value this. This is an idea I value. It'll only take 2 days.
The foundry is already warmed up. I'll make sure to notify you as soon as production is finished.
Excellent. So we're not entirely geared up for the final mission. We pretty much are. I'm thinking that we're gonna give it another month, get the money, get every possible good thing we can get. Because like I said, we are not being pressed terribly hard. Satellite, and then that's it. That's the power of the adjacency bonus. We're getting 5 extra satellites just from that. It's lovely. Of course, now I need money for the power generator. Do I? I don't really need anything else at all. Then there's nothing else I'm going to sell. Okay, now that's some good improvements. Find your weapons to carry more ammunition. Med kit, pistol 2. Aim and critical chance. At the very least, we can expect an increase in the maximum damage output. Nobody told me that would be coming. Also, yes, shivs would be nice. And waiting is probably a ridiculous thing to do. That's a lot of money. You know, given that we activate several alien devices through the course of the game, it's weird that we haven't run across a base mission yet. I'm not sure how they would do it with this lamp, but it would probably be really cool. I just lost my train of thought. Oh yeah. No? Okay. Quests. That means we need to sell items. Normally you never do this. Actually, I might sell some of these because they ain't looking bad. And we're going into the droid business. Lots of berserker corpses. No wonder the reward is so goddamn high. Oof. That's a little tough. Maybe another knight plating? Just in case I'm gonna use another mine ship too. I don't know what the final loadout will be. Yeah. outfit laser cannon. And as soon as it's outfitted, we'll send it somewhere. I don't know. I like having a fire.
Commander, our satellite is prepped and standing by for launch. We are ready to deploy it on your orders.
Good. Our final country. Shame we can't do more satellites just for panic reduction. You know I'd pay for that.
Satellite uplink facilities at maximum capacity. Additional uplink required.
Every nation aside from Argentina. It is a shame to lose them. So yeah, this really is just about as good as it's... I don't know if we'll get that many berserker corpses in that short span of time.
Contact detected.
Ooh. 18. Okay, let's... Oh god, chrysalids. Chrysalids, muton berserkers, muton elites, ethereal sectopod. Okay, they're getting serious. 18, oof. Now's the time, I suppose.
Done it, Commander. Dr. Vollen is confident that this soldier has the power to interact with the alien device. I recommend we get started immediately.
Give it time. He's definitely out for now. Let's get the other suit aside.
Laser pistols.
Get ready to deploy. Our AO is within the continental United States.
Oh, a new map.
Reports indicate the UFO set down in a sparsely populated area. We need to stay sharp and eliminate the invaders.
Yep. You know, we haven't even met their battleships yet. We're loading directly into the UFO.
This is Big Sky. We're in position near the enemy LZ. Strike One is ready to move on your orders.
I read you, Big Sky. This was a landing, not a crash. So expect heavy resistance.
End up enjoying this time very much. so we kind of have to pick a side of the line again, sort of. The monkey cover mechanics are broken up. Taking a different time. is playing out in an interesting way.
What the hell was that?
Guess who's our new coolest guy?